Today I want to talk to you about several solutions you can use to prevent your non-internet programs from accessing the internet. For those who've been paying attention, Audacity just changed their privacy policy. Right now we're looking at my blog. All the posts are pretty much public, so you can check this out yourself. I have now added sections. We're going to talk about all the different solutions you can use to restrict non-internet programs from the internet. And today we're going to be looking at my latest post, which is all the methods to use to block all non-internet programs from the internet. And Audacity is going to be used in this example today. So we're looking at that right now. I'm going to show you the privacy policy, how they changed it first. Then we're going to go over all the solutions. So here is their new privacy policy. It's very concerning. They even changed it to say, if you are under 13 years old, do not use this application. You ever wonder why that is? Well, they have a belief that 13 is the years old where the basically aren't able to consent to data sharing. Well, Audacity, for those who don't know, is a program that allows you to basically modify and edit your audio. I used it in my video here where speakers can become remote listening devices. So they're basically saying in their new privacy policy that user country based on IP address, which means being this vague, we do not know what information could be shared by Audacity to possibly even people they may sell it to. If you look down, who does Audacity share your personal data with? To a potential buyer and its agents and advisor. That's pretty vague. That's pretty open to perception. You could take that a number of ways. So we can't trust Audacity. That's what we've come down to. And I'm going to go over the fix. Keep in mind, any of your programs that don't need the internet, you can use this exact fix, these several fixes that I've come up with a list of. And make sure to subscribe to my channel. I appreciate all my subscribers. Thank you for subscribing and turning on notifications. So do that right now. And I will always try to offer you as many different options as I can come up with. And that's what I try to do differently on this channel. I don't just offer you the standardized solution. I try to come up with different ideas. And what we need to know about privacy and security is, if you're using multiple layers to protect yourself, if one of those layers fails, you have a backup layer. Now keep this in mind, in both privacy and security, this applies. So in many cases, people use one simple layer, maybe firewall, in order to prevent an attacker, an adversary, from violating their security or privacy. But if that firewall fails somewhere, well, then they're obviously going to get through and get your information. So by using multiple layers, which can be completely up to you personally, I'm going to list those different options for non-internet programs right now. You could hold back the updates in your package manager. Keep in mind, this is for all programs. We're just using Audacity based on this new concerning privacy policy. Or you could use FireJail to restrict Audacity's access to the internet, which will completely cut off its ability to share your personal data. So FireJail runs everything in a sandbox. Basically, it creates a new environment that is completely cut off from the internet if you use the flag. As we see right here, the way to run Audacity or another non-internet program inside a sandbox would be FireJail, then dash dash net equals none, and then the program name you want to run. Now, all of your programs can be changed. Use the .desktop files on your Linux system and simply change the exec equals line to include FireJail at the preface, at the front of it. And if you do that with the net equals none, that program, when you click on the button on your desktop or on your menu, it will not have access to the internet. So if it doesn't need the internet, there's no need to enable the internet. Why do programs have access to the internet if they don't need them? So this is something I suggest you do with all of your programs and shortcuts. make sure when they're executed, if they don't need the internet, add that simple line that says fire jail in front of it and net equals none, and you will block those programs from the internet. So that's one option. And let's go to the next option. You could also use Bubble Wrap, which is another sandboxing utility. Now, the difference between Bubble Wrap and Fire Jail, Bubble Wrap does not have super user ID privileges. Now, that could be seen as an advantage because if, say, for example, if Fire Jail was exploited, there's always that possibility that it could increase the privileges of a user that is running that Fire Jail command. So keep that in mind. Bubble Wrap's another option. It doesn't need SUID privileges. It's a sandbox as well. You could also D for another option for non-internet needed programs. You could run it inside a network restricted virtual machine. Now, what's a virtual machine? A virtual machine is something like I'm running right now. I'm actually running a Debian virtual machine. It's a virtual computer. It's an operating system running inside your operating system with a completely restricted set of permissions, privileges, and you can customize that in various ways. For example, you can restrict network access. Next option here, we can run our non-internet program inside Unix. We could use a Tor router, which would mean that if it tries to send your IP address, it would not be able to send that directly. It would send a Tor IP address. So anything you run inside Unix or anything you run with a Tor router as your Wi-Fi or Ethernet connection, it would no longer be able to share your IP address. As we saw in that new privacy policy, the IP address is at risk of being shared with potential buyers, their advisors, whatever that means. That could be anybody, basically, could get your IP address based on this new privacy policy, which I noticed Audacity removed. But we need to keep in mind, if they added these details to the privacy policy, there is a premeditation on this, that they may be violating your privacy in the future. So keep that in mind, even if it's not in the code yet to share all this information on you, you need to realize that. And this can apply to all non-internet programs. Your video player does not need access to the internet. A lot of times with Tor users, they've been de-anonymized by having a special file or a zero-day play inside a video file where it would reveal the user's IP address because they weren't running that video file in a virtual machine, which I do suggest for people who are journalists or someone else who may be working in human rights. You don't need to run that video with a direct connection to the internet for that video program. So you can use one of these many examples to help restrict access, or at least, at the very least, Torify it so that it doesn't have your actual IP address. But keep in mind, you got to mine the metadata and watch my video on metadata I did recently. This can help you have a better understanding of how, even if you're Torifying an application, if you're typing your name in that application, then your name is still going over the Tor network. And if that exit node is compromised and there's no encryption being used, you might have to worry about it if you're a journalist. So make sure you use smart applications, as I mentioned in my video on the actual practice of protecting your metadata. So things like Tor Browser, they help protect your metadata. But keep in mind, you still need to mind the fact that if you're using your Facebook account under your real name, and you're also using other things regarding your human rights or journalism work, those things could potentially be connected by an adversary in, say, a dangerous country or location. So we see here the Torify command. That's another option if you want to Torify. If you don't have a Tor router, hardware router, and you don't have Unix, which connects everything safely through a Tor gateway, watch my video on Unix. I have two of them on Unix so far, and I'll have more coming up. So you can also use the Torify command for non-internet programs. Now, of course, I don't suggest using sudo unless it's a program that needs sudo. That's a typo. I've got to erase that. But keep in mind the Torify command, that can run whatever the program is through Tor. So if it's a program that doesn't need the internet, there's no problem running it through Torify, because that will at least not send your real IP address. So these are all just various options. I thought this list would be fun to come up with. You know, I don't think you need to use all of these options, but I thought it would be fun to come up with a list for my subscribers and supporters who are interested in the various options they may have for restricting a non-internet program from the internet, or at least from direct connections. So here we see a fire jail option, the net equals none Audacity, that restricts networking, so it has no internet access. So if Audacity is trying to send your IP address, your name, and all your other system information, if it has net equals none, Audacity will have no option to do so, because it'll be restricted inside that sandbox. You can also additionally use the private flag, which is something I haven't heard others mention. In addition, I haven't heard anyone else regarding this Audacity topic mention all the different ideas I've come up with here. So make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications. I'll always try to give you the best information and the most options so you can make the choices that work for you. So we could also use a flat pack of Audacity. If you understand what a flat pack is, flat pack is kind of like a sandbox built-in programs. You can also restrict networking in those flat packs. So that's one of the benefits of flat packs, is it kind of includes a sandbox environment for you. So you can use this command here, sudo flatpak override unshare equals network, and then the program that you're restricting from networking. So you can do this with all your flat packs. Keep that in mind. And there's also utilities where you can graphically manage and restrict networking from your different Flatpak based applications. So that's another one. We can also run an older version of the program in mind, and we can also run a fork. And I've included the best fork out there for Audacity that respects your privacy. Cookie Engineer / Audacity. We have an Audacity fork without any Sentry telemetry or crash reporting. And that is where we'll find a lot of that IP address possibly sharing and the other privacy concerns that are current with Audacity. So taking a look at the README description, I will leave a link to this fork here. This one is an updated one. It was updated not too long ago, just 12 days ago, actually 2 days ago. So this is an up-to-date fork of Audacity, removing all of the telemetry and all of the privacy concerns that there are with this current update in their privacy policy. And for those who've been paying attention, I also wrote about the fact that they had added telemetry about a month ago. So Audacity was bought by a private company called Muse, and we need to keep in mind that when these programs get bought by private companies, we can't trust them. And I want to offer you as many options as I can, and I'll leave a link to this safe fork in the description. So those are my many options. You have to keep in mind, not only are you blocking potential IP address leaks and calls home from these non-internet needing programs, which shouldn't have access to the internet to begin with, you're also blocking potential backdoors. Something as simple as a hijacked update could put in a simple reverse shell where someone could have shell access to your user level of privileges. And all you'd have to do is run that outside of a sandbox for that to happen. That would mean your computer, when you open a non-internet program, that would mean your computer would connect out, sending that shell to a remote user and attacker. So these are all things that can happen to non-internet needing programs. And that is why I offer you so many different solutions for them. And I'm just using Audacity as an example here. There's no evidence of this all happening with Audacity yet, but it is the premeditation in the privacy policy that does lead us to get concerned. And so I've offered all of these different solutions for you. You can either pause the screen on where I paste them, and if not, you can also, in the description, I will leave a link to this public post, and you can then read all of your options there. So that's what I have today, guys. I wanted to share another thing to help protect your privacy, and this applies to all non-internet needing programs. You don't need the internet for a program. You should restrict the internet from it. I'm of the belief that, you know, a minimally permissive access for each program is the best policy. And of course, you don't want to go overboard because it becomes complicated to use things. But once you set these things up, you don't have to worry about them anymore. You just simply edit the .desktop files found in your /share/applications or your .local/share/applications directory. That's where you'll find all of your Linux shortcuts and for your desktop. So that's what I have today, guys. Make sure to share this video, like this video, subscribe with the notifications, and I'll be back later with more on how you can protect your privacy.